and healing to answer the cries of the hungry and helpless with the mercy of Christ. What boundless love, what fathomless grace you have shown us, O God of compassion. Each day we live and offering of praise as we show to the world your compassion. What boundless love, what fathomless grace you have shown us, O God of compassion. Each day we live an offering of praise as we show to the world your compassion.
Hi, everybody. Good evening.
Hi.
So glad that you're here to be with us as we celebrate Sue's life and as we also gather to mourn and to cry and to laugh and to eat and to celebrate her. Do you want to hear something funny? Sue is late to her own funeral. Her ashes, her cremation was supposed to be here tonight, but they won't be ready until tomorrow. So, with the family's permission, they let me share that with you as we gather. So she is definitely with us tonight. And so we will gather for her burial at a later date. We want to include everybody that we can in today's service. So if you have a seat next to you that's not being used, just kind of scoot over. If you can share your seat, that would be great. People are welcome to sit on the floor if they need to. And we have room in the parish hall as well, and the service will stream to that room as well. In a few minutes, we're going to start the service with the seating of the family. And we will have communion as part of the service. All of you are welcome and encouraged to receive if you would like. When it's time to come up, if for some reason you can't, just come up and cross your arms and we'll offer a blessing upon you on this day. We have a lot of clergy who are helping with the service today. All of them were dear to Sue in some way. We have Rabbi Jacques, who went with us to the Holy Land, is here with us, and Father Kevin, who served here at St. Thomas for a long time, Mother Martha, who was recently ordained, Mother Kelly, and our Bishop Kathleen is here with us to be part of the service. So that's why they're here, is because they were dear to Sue and dear to all of us. So again, we're just so glad that you're here. Make yourself comfortable, make yourself at home, and if you need something, we have ushers and other people that will help you as we celebrate this great life. So give us just a few minutes and we'll seat the family and get started with the service.
Thank you.
Good evening. Welcome to all of you. Welcome to our friends who are joining us online. Your presence completes us, and we're so glad that you can join us in here, in the parish hall, or in your home. We're gathered together to celebrate, mourn, laugh, and share in the life of Sue Elliott, and also to bring our faith into this moment. So please stand as we sing All Are Welcome.
Build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Hear the love of Christ shall and divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where prophets speak and words are strong and true, where all God's children dare to seek to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness and a symbol of God's grace. Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where love is found in water, wine, and wheat. A banquet hall on holy ground where peace and justice meet. Hear the love of God through Jesus. is revealed in time and space. As we share in Christ the feast that frees us, all are welcome. Where hands will reach beyond the wood and stone, to heal and strengthen, serve and teach, and live the word they've known. Hear the outcast and the stranger, bear the image of God's face. Let us bring an end to fear and danger. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where all are named, where songs and visions heard, and loved and treasured, taught and claimed as words within the word. Built of tears and cries and laughter, prayers of faith and songs of grace. Let this house proclaim from floor to rafter, all are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
I am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awaking, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord. If we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit. For they rest from their labors.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light, grant that your servant Sue, being raised with him, may know the strength of his presence and rejoice in his eternal glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, deal graciously with Sue's family in their grief. Surround them with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we hear God speak to us today in word and sacrament.
A reading from 1 Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own ways. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Please remain seated, and you can join with me as we pray the prayer of St. Francis together. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is giving we receive, it is in pardoning we are pardoned. This time, Gordon Docking is going to share some words with us.
I was asked to speak about Sue, and of course I said yes. It's an honor to be here talking about Sue. She's one of the most important people in my life. But I stand here and look out at this crowd. And what else needs to be said? Look at the number of people that are here. Down here, up there, in the back, in the way back, in the other room. Look at the number of people that loved her. The people impacted by her. The people whose lives were touched by Sue Elliott. This is the most important, powerful statement about Sue right here in this sanctuary that was so important to her. But much to Sue's great disappointment, I have more to say. You all know Sue. She wouldn't want this fuss, right? She would rather be out helping others, which is what she did all of the time. I don't know anyone who is more selfless about helping others than Sue Elliott. She would rather be helping her Special Olympians with sports practice or getting a dance ready for those athletes, or a travel trip for the people in the special needs community, whether it be a camping trip in Nebraska, or a Disney cruise in the Caribbean, or a trip to Disney World in Orlando. That's what she'd rather be doing. I remember her telling me the Disney cruise with the Special Olympics group is great because nobody on a Disney cruise goes to the adult pool, and they had the adult pools to themselves. She did all of that and much more, even starting a program here at St. Thomas for the young adults with special needs who are not getting services because they slipped through the cracks in the system. Those are the things that Sue Elliott did every day. In the last week, I've been reflecting back, trying to think of the moment when Sue Elliott entered my life and my family's life, and you know what? I couldn't think of it. Blake started with Olathe Special Olympics when he was 8 years old, when you could start Special Olympics. But I just don't remember that hurricane moment when that dynamo Sue Elliott suddenly transformed our lives. It wasn't so much a transformation as an evolution. She sort of evolved into our lives, evolving to the point that she really became part of our family, evolving to the point that she became one of the most important people in our lives. Through Special Olympics, Sue created opportunities. Opportunities for Blake to make friends for a lifetime. Friends like Eric and Flint and Jake and Corey, Brian, John, so many others. Guys that have lived together now for 10 years and are truly a second family. But Sue helped bring these guys together way back when Blake was just 8 years old, 1991. That was a long time ago. We have a photo from back then of the team Sue put together for Special Olympics T-ball. It was an interesting group, trying to teach first, second, and third base to guys that couldn't count. But we all had fun, didn't we, Jim? We have a team photo of that team from back then. Blake, Eric, Flint, Corey, Andy, John, and a whole bunch of others, all guys that are friends to this day, friends and like a second family, and Sue helped make this happen. So Sue had her hooks into Blake back then in the early 90s, and then she hooked me into coaching the Olathe Special Olympic swim team. Then my wife Susan and Jake Devine's mom Susan all helped coach, and we continue to help coach. And that will not change. And that's just swimming. How about all those other coaches who have worked for Sue and with Sue and beside Sue for decades? Rose Brenneman, Diana Diaz, Terry Duffy, Becky Franklin, Debbie Byrne, Chris Kling. And I have just barely scratched the surface. If you've coached with Sue or beside her or against her, please stand up and let us know how many people. For all of us, it has been a life-changing experience, thanks to Sue. Sue's world became our world in so many ways. And all the people in Sue's world became our friends. Friends with Sue and friends with each other. One example, Linda Kling met Sue like we all did. And their friendship was very special. They met through Linda's son, Eric. But Linda told me that the two of them, she told me, they just clicked. And right from the beginning, they would finish each other's sentences, quickly becoming best friends. They traveled together, and they felt like sisters, and Linda told me that as sisters, they raised Eric together. Linda and Sue, along with Eric, were best friends and family. That was really Sue's special gift, her superpower. Everyone who met Sue loved her. Everyone wanted to be with her because of her passion and her energy. That superpower that she had made everyone feel like you were her best friend. And I'm going to miss that. But Sue's gift of always... Now it gets personal. Her gift of always being there to help was not just Special Olympics. She was always there if you needed anything. Nearly 10 years ago, I was having a pretty serious health issue and was getting ready for a major surgery, and I'll be honest, I was pretty scared. A couple of days before surgery, Sue showed up with a gift for me. It was a wooden plaque with a message on it, a message I still think about to this day, but it was perfect for me in that moment. It said, "Not to spoil the ending, but everything's going to be okay. It was perfect. It was just what I needed. And that positivity that she demonstrated led me to a great outcome. I stand here, and I still can't believe she's gone. And I know you know that feeling. She had such a dramatic impact on all of our lives. That little tiny body may be gone, but her spirit is too big to be gone. With each one of us, Sue's spirit lives on in our heads, and Sue's spirit lives on in our hearts, and she will always be with us.
Please stand, and we're going to read the gospel for today.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please be seated, won't you? My name is Gar Demo, and I'm one of the priests that serves here at St. Thomas. And I came to St. Thomas a little over 18 years ago. And when I first got here, Sue did not like me. I did not know this, but she was strange because she wouldn't talk to me. It was just a few months before I got here that her husband Chuck had passed away. She was in deep grief and dealing with loss. And the priest that had been here before, Mother Nicolette, who she had walked with her through all of the challenges that she had gone through with Chuck, had left, and I was her replacement, and she would have none of me. She would come to services, and she'd sit in the back, and she would leave as soon as she possibly could. That didn't really change. She would avoid me until one day she had to call me because she wanted to have Chuck's shelter blessed, and the other priest that she called, Nicolette, said, "No, you should call Gar. He's all right." And so she called me and she said, "Would you come out and do that?" I said, "Sure, it sounds like fun." And so, "What do you want to do?" And she kind of gave me a little heads up about who was there. And I came out and Eric and Blake were there and we kind of found each other. I think Morgan was there too. And we all kind of discovered each other. And I was having fun hanging out with them and she decided I was okay. And we started our friendship and our leadership together. I want to take you back to when she was probably about 16 and a poem that she wrote, and I believe she might have read this in a public place in a little crisis that was happening
in her community. There was a facility called Cookson Hills that was setting up satellite places in different communities. They were based in Oklahoma, but they had set up satellites, and they were homes for troubled youth or youth that had challenges. And there was a debate in the city and a challenge as some of the youth, particularly boys, had come into the community, and they were debating about whether to give the park up for them. And Sue and her friend, what was her friend's name?
Montine.
I hope you're here watching. They would steal watermelons and sneak them over to the boys to have. But this is what she wrote when she was 16. This is just wonderful. How many months must we wait to know whether the kids will stay or will go? There's many a place all over this land that wildlife can live, but you must understand kids need a place to work and to play, a place where they're safe all night and all day. Those kids are no different than any of us. There isn't a need for worry or fuss. We want these kids here, and for them we will fight. We know what we want, and we know what is right. We're telling you people, we're telling this town, these Cookson Hill kids are no one to put down. They're good, wholesome kids. They're some of the best. They just got caught, not like all the rest. We are still out and around, still on the run, looking for trouble or some damaging fun. I'm a priest. I think that's a confession. Bill and Mary, you all can confirm that during the reception. These kids are our friends, and we want them to stay. We want them here as they are today. So please, all you people, please have a heart. Give these kids a break and make them know they are a part of your town, of your friends, of all that you do. Show these kids love, and they're going to show you some too. We want our town to be the town too. So come on, everybody, it's up to you. Let's show them we want them. Let's lend them a hand. Let's give them the park and all of its land. That was probably her code for the rest of her adult life, in where she found herself advocating for all of us in this room that we have a place in the world, that we are loved, that we mean something, and that life can be full, and we should be loved and respected and brought into every community wherever we are. And that's the Sue that I knew and loved. She was a fierce social justice advocate for people who were excluded to be included. And not only did she think that, look around at your friends. If somebody has a t-shirt company, I have the t-shirt for you. Live your life so that your funeral requires shuttle service. Look around at all your friends and this community that she has brought together. From Tom's helpers and the people in the church, to her family, to the special needs community, to the coaches and parents, and so many others from throughout every neighborhood and community. She was such a gift to all of us. And this is not easy. I'm not a crier. But I have cried all week, every day, and I'm probably going to, I may cry, I may not. I'm crying inside, just know. Because that bright light won't answer the texts anymore, won't call me and tell me something that's not quite right, won't show up late to something very important that she's supposed to be at. Won't lose her keys or her wallet in obvious places. But that bright light won't be right next to us in the same way that she's always been. The passages from Scripture that we chose today have to do maybe with things that you're used to hearing them at as weddings. Love is patient, love is kind. We hear that as the admonition to couples as they're getting married, but it's actually a mantra for all of us to truly live by in our relationships. I knew Sue's faith. It was deep and abiding and very real to her. And I think if I were to find a piece of Scripture that encapsulate who I thought she was and who she was trying to live out being, it was this Scripture. That she showed love to all of us because of the love that she felt from God. She'd been through some stuff. Today's not today to get into all that. She had had experiences in her life that were difficult. She had seen some of the underbelly of the world and the difficult reality. She knew pain and she knew suffering, but she also deeply knew God's love. And that's what she lived out to all of you. In the joyfulness of her gathering of her friends and communities in so many different ways. She was happiest with all of us. She was happiest and most fulfilled when she could love us, and even though sometimes she wasn't so great at taking love from us. And that's part of why she was the amazing person that she was. Now, Bill and Mary, another reason Sue and I were such good friends is we're both youngest children. That's all I'm going to say. We're playful. We miss things. We're not to take anything seriously. We're irresponsible, and we were spoiled through our entire life. Is that fair? Yeah, okay. This is why we became friends. But she loves you guys with all her heart and your families. She loved being with you, and there was always a highlight for her when she would head to Colorado and Florida, and it was something she looked forward to every time it happened and every time she could be with you. She always loved you, even in the sibling stuff, which we all know and we all have. She loved you. You were her heart and her soul. Sabrina, in the last few years, you and Sue have come together to share your life, and you have found a wonderful friendship, and she was so grateful for you and your presence in her life and your partnership. And I know we will be with you as you grieve and walk with you in this loss. And all of this family that's gathered here and our friends, we have grief to go through together. It's okay to cry. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to find in a moment that you might not realize that you're missing Miss Sue and you wish she was there. But tell each other. Tell each other. Talk about her. Say her name. And don't be afraid to let those tears flow and to let your heart feel what you're feeling. You were important to her, and I know she was so important to many of you. Will all of our Special Olympics folks and special folks please stand? You are her family. You are beautiful and wonderful, and we are so glad that she brought you into all of our lives. She even got me to volunteer every once in a while at ski things and other places. I think I did a couple overnights with you, and I'll do that. Now, here's the other challenge for all of us. I heard that poem that she had written, and I kept thinking we're all going to miss her. And I know Shannon, I think the new director that has the job that Sue had, she needs our support and our love. Did I get the name right? I'm sorry if I didn't. Did I say it right? Help me out. New director of Special Olympics. Shannon, yeah, I got it right. Okay. I was like, what? You need our support. Where are you? You were here earlier. So I saw you. She was here earlier. But you need our support and our love, and we all need to stay committed to those special things. We have Tom's helpers here at St. Thomas, and this is a legacy for her. And we have all her other legacies in the community that she did. And so I encourage you to stay committed to those things and to be there and to help those programs continue to grow, as there are 8-year-old children looking for the same community many of you have had and needing that same presence. And they need you to be Sue's for them. The hard days are ahead. Tomorrow it gets quieter, and we'll start to feel that Sue is gone. I want you to think a little bit about leaning on each other. We're going to sing a beautiful song in a minute about what that means for us as our community continues to grieve. Just call on me when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I might have a problem, you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there's a load you have to bear that you can carry on, it's right up the road to share your load. Just call. So I encourage you to lean on each other. Maybe you'll hear Sue's voice quietly. Maybe you'll think you'll see her. Maybe you'll find her in the sunlight or on a gentle rain at 6:30 in the morning on Easter Sunday, just as we start a service outside. Or the fact that her ashes aren't quite here yet. Or in the quiet stillness of our heart. Or you might think you see her standing there at one of your meets, one of your competitions. Or you might hear her voice quietly in your head. Take it as a gift of her presence. Her family was with her on the day she died. Her friends, we gathered, she was prayed for, she was trying. She wanted to live, but her body was sick. We don't know all the reasons. We don't know all the whys. We just know that she's gone. But what I know, I am so grateful that I met her 18 years ago. I am so grateful that I could call Sue my friend. I am so grateful for this community and all these beautiful people sitting here that Sue brought into my life. I am so grateful that Sue stood up for all the boys and girls and said they are here and they are loved. And so we say to Sue, well done, good and faithful servant. Well done. Now let's lean on each other. Amen.
Just call me, lean on. when you're not strong.
I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for
it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on me when you're not strong. And I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on me when you're not strong. And I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Call me, oh baby, just call me. Call me, I'm telling you, call me. Call me, oh baby, just call me.
Like, please stand in the assurance of eternal life given at baptism. Let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator.
Our sister Sue, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Sue and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raise the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister Sue. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Please greet one another in the name of the Lord, and peace to our friends online as well. I wanted you to come and so that the family. So you're a big part of her life. Hey, Shan. Hey, Shan. Hey, Tiffany. How are you doing, sweetheart? Thank you so much. I hope you're doing okay. It's a lot. Good to see you guys. Hey. How are you doing? You painted this room.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, good to see you guys. Hey, Jordan, how are you? Love you. Good to see you. Peace. Good to see you all. Peace. Good to see you all. Peace. Good to see you all. Peace with you. Glad to have you all here. Peace. Peace, Jim.
Peace and love.
Peace, Jim. You want us to bring communion, or are you going to come out?
Come on.
Okay. Peace. Hey, good to see you. Peace, y'all.
Oh, thank you so much. That was a wonderful home.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. Sir, I'm so sorry.
Love you.
We'll stay. Yeah, love you too. Yeah. We'll stay in touch. Yeah.
We got to.
Yeah, oh yeah. I'm so sorry. Connie, I'm so sorry for your loss. Mary, I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Bill, I'm so sorry. When we get ready to do communion, you guys are fine, but just kind of slip over here so people can move around.
Just against it all, kind of.
Yeah. Y'all can be seated, sir. Sometimes that's the best part of the service, when we get to say hi to each other. We're going to offer communion. All of you are welcome to come forward to receive if you would like. The ushers will guide you to come down this middle aisle. There'll be two people handing out bread. They'll just give it to you in your hands. You just put your hands out, they'll put a little piece in, you can go ahead and eat that. There'll be some chalice, people holding chalices. So you know in our church we use real wine, so it does have that flavor if you aren't expecting it. You can get a little cup, and one of the people will have a chalice they can pour, or you can drink from one of the chalices, too, if you would like to. You can also not have the chalice. You can have one or the other. If for some reason you're not able to receive, but you want to come up to participate, just come up and cross your arms, and we'll offer God's blessing on you this day. Again, all of you are welcome to come forward to receive. We're glad to welcome you here at St. Thomas. After the service, the family will head out with us into the parish hall. And all of you are welcome to come. There's a great, wonderful spread of delicious food and a chance for you to visit with each other. Please tell some Sioux stories with each other. Make sure to come and greet everybody and to give each other support and love as well. And again, we're just so glad that all of you are here on behalf of the family and Sabrina and everyone. We're just so glad that you have come to celebrate our dear Sue and to wish her well and to mourn together and to laugh and all of those things. Again, we're just so glad that you're here. Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
if I but call your name. Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call? Still stare, should your life a drought or scare, will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me? Will you let the blinded see if I but call your name? Will you say prisoners free and never be the same? Will you kiss the leper clean and do such as this unseen and admit to what I mean in you and you in me? But call your name. Will you quell the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around through my sight and touch and sound in you and you? Your summons echoes true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go where your love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow in you.
Please stand. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen. Our service continues on page 13. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross, offering himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this prayer, this bread, and this wine. We pray, you gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ. Bring us to that heavenly country, where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, glory forever and ever. Amen." Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Please be seated, won't you? We're going to allow the people who are in the parish hall to come over to receive communion first, and then the ushers will guide the rest of you. So if our ushers could go get the folks in the parish hall to come on over. And then we'll get started with them. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and I will raise you up on angels' wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
But he will fear
the terror of the night, nor the arrow thousands fall about you. Near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night.
Me.
wind and flame. I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. You and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. To you, the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Favor be upon you and a thousand generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you. He is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, and your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, 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 he is for you. Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
On page 18, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. You have fed us with spiritual food and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and to serve you, gladness and singleness of heart.
So with our bishop's permission, we were going to do the commendation. Even though Sue's not with us, we will pretend.
We're commending her tomorrow.
Yes, yeah. So please join with me. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant Sue with your saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more, life is sighing, but life everlasting.
You only are immortal, creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Sue. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the company of the glorious saints in light. Our bishop will now offer a blessing, and then our rabbi will also be offering a blessing at the end.
For us, saints are those beloved of God. It is everyone who is united by being beloved of God, by loving others. Today, I think, is a beautiful vision of the saints. I was moved to be here and to see it. And we now ask God's blessing, thinking of Sue. May God, who has bound us together in the company of the elect in this age and the age to come, attend to the prayers of your faithful on your behalf. May God, who has given us in the lives of saints patterns of holy living and victorious dying, strengthen our faith and devotion and enable us to bear witness to truth against all adversity. May the risen Christ, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, who reminds us that there is a communion with those beloved of you that extends forever. God of peace, the great shepherd of the sheep, make you perfect in every good work to do God's will, working in you that which is pleasing in God's sight. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Creator, Redeemer, Sustainer, be with you all, now and forever.
And I'll be reciting the Kaddish. I'd like to point out two things about it. That unlike most of our prayers that are in Hebrew, the Kaddish is in Aramaic. It's one of very few prayers in Aramaic. And that's the language that Jesus spoke. So creating here a bond between us, a bond that I certainly felt very keenly with Sue. Also, the unique thing about the Kaddish is that it doesn't speak about death, but rather it praises God in accepting God's desire, in making us instruments of God's will, as Sue was. So I will. Itkadal veitkada shemei rabba, be'alma divrachi rutei ve'amlich malchutei, בחייכון וביומכון, ובחיי דכל בית ישראל, בעגלה ובזמן קריב, ואמרו, אמן. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם ולעלמי עלמיה. התברך והשתבח, והתפאר, והתרומם, והתנשא, והתאדר, והתעלה, והתעלה, על שמי דקודשה, בריחו. לאלה, מן כל ברכתה ושירתה, תושבחתה ונחמתה, דאמירם בעלמה, ואמרו, אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה, וחיים טובים עלינו ועל כל ישראל, ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל, ואמרו אמן. And to our sister Sue, I say, לכי כשירכך אדוני, go your way for God has called you. לכי והיה אדוני עמך, go your way and may God be with you. והלך לפניך צדקך, כבוד אדוני יאספך. May your righteousness go before you and the glory of God receive you. Amen.
Sue would have taken a picture. Let's fly away.
Life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away, fly away, fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by. Shadows of this life have grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars has flown, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. Fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away, fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, fly away, fly away. Fly away, oh glory. Fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. Shore, I'll fly away, fly away, fly away.